of HDFC Bank now joins us. Mr. Puri, this is Nikunj Dalmia from ET Now. These are difficult and trying times for all of us. So first, I'm sincerely hoping that everybody, that your family, you yourself, and all the employees of HDFC Bank are safe.
They are very safe. We have taken very good action. We have all the people who can work from home are working from home. Hello, Nikunj, I can't hear you.
Yes, sir, we can hear you. Please go ahead.
Okay, so basically, also we have arranged buses which are sanitized to transport our people from areas of concentration. So that is working very well, and we're doing our best to keep everybody safe. We've got floor marshals, we've got doctors on call, we've got all the sanitizers, we're handing out masks, so we're doing everything possible.
What is your read of the situation, Mr. Puri? How bad it has got? Because bad has become terrible and terrible has become horrible. Horrible has become a nightmare.
नहीं मेरा निकुंज थोड़ा view थोड़ा different है. First, let us understand that this is basically a biological and a health issue. Hello?
Yes, sir, we can hear you.
Yeah, so this is a biological and a health issue, and the first thing we have to do is to make sure we control the virus. So I am very happy, even though the stock market has reacted negatively to the lockdown, I feel after 10 days we should see if there is a control or if there is a flattening of the curve. Otherwise, we should do another 15 days.
Right.
Because the main thing is the moment we have controlled the virus, everything else will fall in place and we have a very good opportunity. So my first thing is, let us understand that this is a health issue, it's not a financial issue.
Right.
Now coming to the second part of it again, however, we will also have life after the coronavirus. All crises, Nikunj, sound as if they are doom each time, but they also pass. So simultaneously, we have to look to ensure that life continues both now as well as after the virus. Three things I can see what can be done by, one on the fiscal, one on what we can do on the monetary side and what we can do on the fiscal side. But first thing first, the lockdown, social distancing, making sure we follow the hygiene methods, and it is up to us to save ourselves and the country. Now we come to the monetary side. On the monetary side, very clearly, for stability and stability in the yields, as well as giving the straight answer that we are well behind it, we do need a repo rate cut. That's number one. Number two, we need forbearance for the cash flow issue that would be created by the virus. Now, this in no way is being linked to an NPA problem. No, it's not an NPA problem. It's a cash flow problem for perfectly healthy companies. So we must create and give them both whatever forbearance is necessary for them to keep these companies going. Third is, we should forget about the FRBM and whatever money we save on oil, we should, as well as whatever additional leeway we can have, we should do that to set up the infrastructure for sorting the health, that is more ventilators, more confinement centers, because we will need this in the second stage. It will be higher than this, but we are still well positioned if we plan in advance. I think they are moving, we need to move further, but that is the first issue. Then again, we have to look at very clearly that we see, you know, everybody says what is happening to the banks, what is happening to the banks. But yeah, the banks, whatever will happen to the banks is what happens to the economy. So for the banks who have a good portfolio, like our portfolio is investment grade, our risk rating on the total portfolio is 4.3, which is A. And that is right across there, and so any cash flow temporary difficulties will not create that much of a problem. And just for your information, Nikunj, I am sitting on surplus cash of $5 billion and money is still coming in. The funny part is, semi-urban and rural India thinks the crisis is not there. So let's make sure we don't land the crisis there by people migrating back. So net-net, is it an issue? Yes. Let us not try and solve everything at one go. The first is the health issue. simultaneously we look at whatever we can do to make the life of people comfortable through essential services, and also solve the cash flow problem, and spend like hell to make sure the health issues are sorted out, as well as we create employment at the right time.
Okay. In your experience, Mr. Puri, do you think an uptick could happen on retail delinquency, not for HDFC Bank, your book is great, but across for other banks and other NBFCs?
See, again, retail delinquency now depends on the kind of retail. Retail bahut generic ho gaya. Now, let's take for people who have said, let's take our unsecured loans which people have been focusing. Firstly, they are only approximately 6% or 8% of the portfolio, and 80% of this lending is to top tier corporate salary. Now, this can have a delay, but it won't really have that much delinquency go up. Our SME, 80% has additional collateral. So we are very secured, and we would be able to give additional money to tide him over as well. And our delinquencies here have not been high. So till now, actually, we were doing quite well. Some of the journalists asked me, do you expect a disastrous quarter? And I said, absolutely not. So, yet temporary, the business potential, and like my friend Ramdeo said, the value of the franchises have not gone down. The value of the stock will go down, because there's a difference between looking at it 3 months and looking at it long term.
Understand that, sir. So, I'm not going to get into where stock prices are, but in general, do you think that the panic in global financial markets is overdone?
I think the panic in global financial markets will always be overdone. Nikunj, when there is something like this, panic is always overdone. And there's no point fretting about how many circuit breakers we hit.
But
the moment the health issue is sorted out, this could actually, if you see previous crises, they spread over 2 years and 3 years. This could be a crisis if we either contain it or we find a virus in even 6 to 9 months, will probably be the shortest crisis.
So, Mr. Puri, I don't want to get this one wrong. Your communication to your shareholders and our viewers is that you don't expect there is going to be a large retail delinquency, at least in your book.
In my book, no. Absolutely correct. In fact,
what about? Yes, sir.
Pucho, Nikunj.
No, please go ahead. I just interpreted your thought there.
So, before we go, we're mixing two things, Nikunj, jara dekhlo. One is an NPA issue, one is the problem created by this cash flow. Ye dono mix karoge to will they, Bich-bich mein sunai nahi de raha Nikunj.
No, my question is, one is the NPA issue and second is the cash flow issue. So the NPA issue for forbearance is not announced. Do you think there is going to be a huge challenge?
No, I think NPA issue on forbearance, they don't have an option, they will have to announce. There is no discussion on the aaj karo, kal karo, parso karo, ye to announce karna padega.
Okay. Now, what about...
Nikunj, I didn't hear your question. Fir pooch.
Yeah. My next question is, sir, I'm not talking about HDFC Bank, but I'm talking about, let's say, rest of the banking sector. Banks have always managed to get a lot of capital because of vibrant stock markets. Now that stock prices have come down, a lot of banks which were growing because of raising capital, could they be in a tough spot?
Now, capital raise ho gaya na, Nikunj. Nikunj, I can't hear you. Let me answer the first bit.
Yes, sir.
Now, most banks have raised their capital and are sitting on capital adequacy like we are sitting, and a lot of others are sitting on a capital adequacy of 17.5. Kisi ko agar abhi jarurat hai capital ki, then I can't beat around the bush, usko thodi mushkil hoegi.
Okay. What do you think needs to be done on the corporate side? For example, there is a huge tax on buyback. There is LTCG. Do you think, apart from the relief on forbearance, those are other measures which should be announced, because there are good companies, Mr. Puri, they are sitting on a lot of cash, especially IT companies, especially pharma companies. This is a time.
I think that's a very good idea, Nikunj. I think it's a very good idea. Hello?
Yes, sir, we can hear you.
And the tax collected on this is peanuts, yeah, and the sentiment change will be so much, so it's a very good idea.
Mr. Puri, you've seen many crises. You've seen the 2008 crisis. That time it appeared that, you know, the financial markets would end. 2001, after terrorist attack, it appeared that, you know, World War III would start. After the TMT bubble, it thought that winter would collapse. So do you think these difficult and dark days should also pass away?
I mean, always it will pass away. Yaar, you may be bitiya nahi, you are asking me like my bitiya asked me, you think this is the end of the world? And I said, no.
So what did you tell her apart from no, sir?
I told her three things. One, all crises pass. Two, remain calm. Three, make sure we solve the health thing and everybody functions responsibility. Four, thoda meditate karo. Five, this will pass 100% and it's probably a shorter crisis than the ones we have had before.
Mr. Puri, just one last follow-up question, that if you look at what other governments have done on the fiscal side, you know, we are looking at US announcing a fiscal stimulus which runs into trillions of dollars. We are looking at every government coming out and talking about fiscal stimulus. Do you think the government support should just go beyond a forbearance and a tax cut? This is time where you need to think out of box, don't get carried away because of rating agencies and everybody else?
I don't think, I am very sure. We need to live to fight another day. Nikunj, tumhara nahi sunai de raha mere ko.
I've got you in a terrible line, sir, but I think we got your points. Thank you very much for joining us.
Last thing that you asked, yes. Let me tell you, you have to live to fight another day. Whatever we can do, fiscal deficit is the least important thing just now.
Okay, really appreciate the time, sir.
When they came into a business, kya tha fiscal deficit? 5 point something, no?
Right, sir.
And to phir kya problem hai? वो भी सॉल्व हो गया, आ गया था, अगर ये वायरस नहीं होती तो आ गया था 3.5 में, अब ले जाओ 5 में, क्या प्रॉब्लम है?
ओके, सो द सिंपल मैसेज फ्रॉम यू मिस्टर पुरी इज दैट गो आउट ऑल आउट ऑन स्पेंडिंग, कंजूसी नहीं करनी चाहिए.
बिल्कुल.
ओके, देयर इज अ यू नो पंच इन योर वॉइस मिस्टर पुरी एंड आई वाज लुकिंग फॉर दैट पंच. यू आर द मोस्ट ऑप्टिमिस्टिक पर्सन वी हैव इंटरेक्टेड विद फ्रॉम द मॉर्निंग, सो थैंक यू फॉर योर यू नो रीअश्योरेंस एंड थैंक यू फॉर पुटिंग ऑल योर एक्सपीरियंस. And thank you for, you know, your wisdom.
Thank you, Nikunj. Pleasure talking to you. And don't look, itna ura hua mat look. Itna ura hua mat lag.
I'm joining from Skype, sir, but the sentiment which sometimes takes the better on you. Really appreciate your time. And thank you for your optimistic voice. Well, that's Aditya Puri. You know, such a positive and a constructed person. This shall also pass away. Remember that. That's one thing which I guess can really change our whole attitude and approach towards this crisis. I know there's a crisis. I know there is a medical crisis, an economic crisis. But ultimately, this shall also pass away. Like Sir John Templeton once famously said, the 5 more dangerous words in the market are this time is different. In a bull market or in the bear market, trust me, there is nothing which is different. I am confident, I am certain. And now that, you know, we heard from Mr. Puri also what the entire state of the banking sector is, let's hope and pray that this shall also pass away very soon. Let's take a break for the moment.